So the dragons have returned. Well, the Skarl have survived worse.
Attended the storm, learning his ways.
This secret white means.
Her name is Ford. And I'll be silent.
It's been many winters since my husband.
I came here to study the history of Solstheim, but it's the Skarl who intrigued me the most. Well, let me think. I suppose it's been nearly a year now. My goodness, how the time has flown. Well, not so far. They think I'm a bit strange, but they seem to tolerate me. In fact, they've been very accommodating, hospitable even. They seem happy to talk about their traditions and history. Oh, no, most certainly not. I'm a historian. I'm here to learn about the history of Solstheim. Solstheim is a fascinating place. We know so little about its past. There are many mysteries that remain unsolved. Yes, that was a most disturbing experience. But to answer your question, the architecture was strange, almost otherworldly. Given that, and the considerable power it must have taken to affect our minds so completely, it would suggest the work of a powerful mage. Either that, or perhaps a Daedra. If so, then may the Nine protect us. Powerful and malevolent entities who make their home on the Plane of Oblivion. Some of the more powerful among them can exert their influence within our world. And when they do, men inevitably suffer. Take care now.
I welcome you, friend of the Skarl.
I do enjoy.
time to die!
Where'd you come from?
Filthy fetcher!
The twilight watches us all, Guardian. What do you need to take? Until next time, Guardian.
I'm no fan of the sun. It would be better than this.
From that look on your face, I'm guessing you've never seen a Silt Strider before. This is Dusty. I personally trained her for Malava. Feels like a lifetime ago now. She hasn't been in traveling condition for quite a while now. I've tried to let her go off on her own, but she insists on staying here. We get bar trading odds and ends with the locals. I've decided to stay here and make sure she passes in peace. It's the least I can do for her. Every once in a while, a local makes it out here, although they usually just want to catch a glimpse of Dusty. Silt Striders are pretty rare now. What would you like to know? The blast from the volcano wiped most of them out. Found Dusty in a small cave on Vardenfell. Silt Strider cocoons are pretty tough. Mostly for transporting goods and people. They were pretty commonplace in Morrowind, but that was ages ago. A Silt Strider carapace is so strong, it can withstand the harshest of weather. Even the legendary sandstorms of Vardenfell's Molag Armor region were said to barely make a dent in them. Of course, that's all ash now. All right.
Safe travels.
Until next time, Guardian. The twilight. Fine. What?
What?
Still have something you need? Yes. Fine. What?
What?
Will do. Will do. Will do. That it?
Now through him do we see. Our hands once were idle. Now through them does he speak. And when the world shall listen.
I don't care if he's a master wizard. He can't treat me like this. That Fetcher told me to fix his house. If I don't, he'll find a new house.
Aren't you supposed to be in the tower assisting my...
Why won't this summoning work? If you must know, I am trying to get this Ash Guardian spell to work. Now let me concentrate. Besides, shouldn't you be worrying about the damage to the tower?
Master Neloth has tasked Alenia with repairing the tower.
Nothing.
Where it would be safer for all of us.
The lab is too small. Also, I need the ashy soil. Master Neloth knows what I'm doing. No need to bother him about it, though. He's quite busy at the moment.
It's on your head if something goes wrong. Just let me get back inside.
No Ash Guardian. Maybe the book has something.
We don't get many visitors. Is there something you need? Tel Mithrin. It's the home of Master Neloth. You may have heard of him. He's a famous Telvanni wizard. In Morrowind, the Telvanni grow buildings from special fungus spores. Master Neloth grew one here to be his home. Don't ask me how. No, Talvis is his apprentice. I'm his steward. I manage the day-to-day affairs of Tel Mithrin.
Until next time.
That doesn't even make sense. I'll just ignore that part.
You again? Didn't I see you in Ravenrock? You refer to the tomes of esoteric knowledge that old Hermaeus Mora has scattered throughout the world? Is this somehow connected to your search for Mira? Found one? Yes. And you read it too, didn't you? Don't try to deny it. You've got the look. I can see it now. Dangerous knowledge is still knowledge, and therefore useful. Usually turns out to be the most useful, in my experience. Now that is a dangerous path indeed. Hermaeus Mora gives nothing away for free. You may end up like Mirak, of course. Two power mad dragonborn. It could be very interesting. Oh yes. They're not hard to locate once you know how to look for. I have one here that I've been using to locate more. Yes, I haven't been idle while this fascinating madness engulfed Solstheim. But my book isn't what you're looking for. I'm quite sure it is unconnected with this Mirak. But I do know where to find a black book that can help you. Yes, I do. I haven't been able to get it, though. But maybe together we can unlock the secrets the Dwemer left behind. Forbidden knowledge was somewhat of a specialty of the dwarves, eh? You don't think they would just leave it alone, do you? It seems the ancient Dwemer discovered this book and took it to study. I found their reading room in the ruins of Nachardak. The book is there, but it's sealed in a protective case, which I wasn't able to open. But perhaps the two of us together will be able to get at the book. To Nachardak, then. Follow me.